I think I gave a good showing. There's no really solidified spots here. It's weekly basis here with the coaches. We get grades, and whoever plays better is the one who starts. And Coach Sweeney said, yeah, there has to be someone who runs out there first, but if you deserve to play, you're going to play. But I'm going to try to keep the spot as hard as I can, but I don't think it's definitely solidified. It's definitely a competition per week, and Cade, he's back healthy, and he's a really good competitor, a really good player, so someone who's going to push me all season. Yes, sir. I think I've gotten better for sure with I took off the glove on my right hand, so I feel like I got a little bit better control with it and more just like feeling the ball and being able to actually know where I want to put it rather than having that glove there. So I think it's helped a lot.
How do the nerves of a season opener and the adrenaline compare to the games during the regular season, the playoff and all that?
I think every game is nerve-wracking until you get that first hit in. You're going to have butterflies in your stomach and you're going to be kind of queasy. But opener is just a lot of unknowns. You don't know. We've had a long time to prepare. They've had a long time to prepare for us. So you just don't know truly what they're going to bring out there. So I guess that's a little bit more nerve-wracking. But we practice with a purpose here and we try to play to a standard. And that kind of calms your nerves a little bit for sure. We just have to play for Clemson, play for our standard.
Dabo says he doesn't fall down the hill on Thursday night. Is that something you guys think about?
Yeah, if you guys ever watch me go down the hill, I almost walked down that thing. I'm so terrified to fall down it. We've had guys fall down it before, and there's pictures put up in the weight room afterwards. I don't want to be one of those guys. So I'm almost walking down this hill when I go down.
Tyler Davis has been talked about a lot throughout camp. What is it about him that makes him so good?
He's just a hard-nosed player. I mean, he got low center of gravity. He just works hard. He doesn't act like a freshman. He's really smart. He's just been about his business since he's gotten here. And he wants to play, and he's proven that he deserves to play. So I'm excited to see what he does against someone else.
Is that hard to do as a freshman to come in right away, especially on the line, and be able to, I guess, do what he's done?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, a lot of guys can handle it mentally, but it's the physical aspect of it. And he's a really strong kid, and mentally he picked up. I think he knew most of the calls by the end of spring. So for sure, I think him having another install fall camp helped out a lot. But I think he's done well. I mean, in today's college football, everybody wants to play early, but sometimes it's kind of hard. Sometimes your body's not physically ready to play as a freshman, but his was.
Sean, talk about how much your role has changed since you first came here. I mean, obviously, you're probably doing a lot of the same things football-wise, of course. But now you're a leader, veteran. How much has your role changed?
Well, it's just realizing that even if you don't think about it, the young guys are looking up to you, and just everything you do, how you carry yourself, that's how they're going to handle themselves. So a little thing of just making sure I run quickly off the field or just to pay attention to little details just tells the freshmen and the young guys who haven't played that, okay, he's doing it. There's a reason why he's doing it. He's been in the big game, so maybe we should listen to him. But football-wise, it's more or less, I'm trying to go into like a solidified starter role, as we talked about earlier. So it's a little bit different rather than being a backup. So it's been exciting. I'm just excited and just knowing that I'm the older guy now and just people are looking up to me. It's just been going to be an exciting year.
Sean, what have you seen on tape so far for
Georgia Tech? They play hard like they always do. And that's one thing I'll say about Georgia Tech. They always have pride and their program is very prideful and they'll come in, they're going to smack you in the mouth. And that's how they always play. And with his new coaching staff, they're known for bringing energy to the field. And you can see it like in the spring game, the head coach is hype, he's yelling, he's getting his players. And you just tell it, his players are feeding off it, how much energy they have. And it's just, that's the big thing, is they're going to hit you hard. They're going to be ready to play. Georgia Tech ain't intimidated by anybody. They're going to come here and give us our all. And that's exciting for someone as a senior, you just knowing that you're going to get the best out of everybody. It makes it more exciting on game day.
Is there any kind of a different vibe around the team opening with an ACC opponent as opposed to opening with a Furman or a Kent State?
It's a one-game mentality always, and it's we prepare for everybody. We would prepare to play for Clemson. If you were preparing to play for us, you take it seriously. That's what we do for every opponent. You can get beaten on any day by anybody. It doesn't matter who you play. So if you don't take it seriously, you're very susceptible to losing, and we don't want to do that. So we take every opponent seriously and make sure that we give them utmost respect, because they're preparing to win as well. So why don't you give them respect by doing as much as you possibly can?
Sean, how has it been practicing against a defensive line that doesn't include Christian and Dexter and Clay?
Oh, it's been different for sure, but the young guys, they're all so talented. So Clemson recruits so well. So just you see the flashes and the sparks, and it's like once they all get it, it's gonna be like, wow, they can be some great ones that come through here. It's just different. I mean, we're the old guys now, and then they Christian, Clea, all of them were old guys before. So just we know we're a little more savvy. We've been there. We know a little bit more of the system. But once it fully clicks, it's gonna be crazy. I don't know, honestly. I mean, Gage is an athlete. He can play wherever you put him. I mean, I'm sure it might take him a little bit. I'm sure he could adjust the tackle if he needed to. But he's just an athlete. He's a really good player. He's a smart player. So it kind of helped that I was able to take on center so well, and he was able to take on guard so well. It kind of just worked out. I don't know if coaches might say it's more natural, but I don't know. I don't really look at it as that.
You guys will have off on Saturday. Will you try to watch Kelly and or Hunter play at their new schools at all?
I'm going to try to watch as much college football as I can. I don't have cable. It costs too much money. I'm a big Netflix guy. My mom pays for Netflix. So I'm going to try to find somewhere I can go watch it at. But my family's coming to town. I haven't seen my mom and dad, and one of my best friends back home are coming. I haven't seen them in a while, so I think I'm just going to hang out with them, just catch up and bringing my dog back, so I get to see her. I haven't seen her in a couple weeks, so I'm excited just to hang out, maybe watch a bit. I know Kelly's going to do great, and so will Hunter. They're both really good competitors, and they both seem really happy where they're at, so I know they're going to do great no matter what.
And having the weekend off, just playing on a Thursday night, does that add a little extra to this opener as opposed to just kicking it off maybe on a noon on Saturday, your prime time Thursday night?
Not really. I mean, if you don't go out and play well, it's a really long weekend, and it's a weekend you don't want to be a part of. So, I mean, I don't think about after the game. I mean, I think about going into the game and knowing what I have to do and what the team's got to do. And if we hit our goals that we want to, we're going to be successful. And I hope there's no one that has a mentality of wait until after the game. That's a horrible mentality to have, because if we don't do what we got to do, one, it's going to be rough meetings the next couple of days, and it's a long three-day weekend that you don't want to be part of as a competitor. So I hope people are focused, and I think we are. We have a great team, great. Even though we're young, but everybody's focused and strong mentally. Just everybody's great competitors. As I've said before in previous interviews, just it's kind of crazy the drive and the competitiveness of this team at such a young age. And I think everybody's just excited to kind of hit someone else for once. It's been a long fall camp, and Coach Sween, all the coaches do a great job with the camp, but we're ready to get going. I would think so. I mean, he's physically there. There's no question about that. And mentally, he's got a lot thrown at him. I mean, but he was able to go through a spring and a fall, so it helped out a lot. And then once we could get into game planning and stuff, he'll be able to learn more, especially with having older guys. I think so. Mentally, he's there, and he's stepped up his game, so he shows that he wants to play. And I think he proved to coach that he deserves to.
Anything else?
Sean, thank you, Sean.